Welcome everybody to August KI Live here. As you just saw, we have a very special show for you today with a little teaser there. That was kind of a pre-teaser. My name is Spark. I go by Batmasterson and Pirate 101 Spark in Wizard 101. I am joined here by several of those who you may know from all of our KI Live shows and also a couple of guests. Welcome to the show, Professor Velmea, Decius, Vanessa Mythdust, our regulars, and then our special guest, Sam Johnson, head of writing, and Adam Roush, concept artist. Now that may give you a little hint into what we are going to be talking about today. A little bit of that pre-teaser there that you saw at the very beginning of the show was a silhouette of a special concept art piece hand-delivered to us by Nana herself from Nana's Karamelle Delights. And we have Adam to talk about that, and then Sam will also be talking a little bit later about some of the story and writing. And we do know we have seen a lot of activity in the community recently on the story for this upcoming world. And
we
know, right, Leah, that we know there is so much that the community wants to hear more of, not just for this world, but just in general for Wizard 101. And so
absolutely,
we have a little bit of that.
Absolutely.
A few things to just quickly get out of the way here. We will be answering your gameplay questions, the pre-submitted ones. Thank you, everybody, for submitting some really fantastic questions and also for some great gameplay tips. So we have a few of those later in the show to sprinkle in there. We also will, if time is permitting, seeing how things go, we may have a chance to take a few key questions from Twitch chat, but that please always for the next show, if you don't get your question answered this time, don't worry, just ask for the next show. Anybody who had a pre-submitted question or tip will get a nice 5,000 crowns that if it's answered on the show. We also have a couple of special giveaways, and thanks to Kaylee, Vanessa Mythdust, as well as Decius for putting those together, and I will actually say what those giveaways are for Wizard 101.
I
just love giving these away, and you know what, it's
you know what,
kind of a sweet
let's do it. Oh yeah. It is very, very, very sweet.
So we will give them away a little bit later in the show. I don't want to give the code out right now, but I will tell you what they are, so you'll have to stay tuned, everyone, just a little bit later in the show when we have a little bit of a break where it's like, yeah, let's give it away now. We won't wait until the end. Don't worry about that unless we forget or something. Let us know in the chat if it's like past 4:30 and you're like, where's that code? And then you can help remind us. So the code we will have once that's revealed for Wizard 101, you get 2 Rockhammers jewel packs, and for Pirate 101, 2 Tribal Crew packs. So that's 4 packs. That's pretty cool for 2 games. There you go. So hopefully you enjoy those. A lot of you probably know which ones those are, and good luck on getting some good stuff out of them. I think what I will talk about next is more giveaway stuff, because gosh, we have so much that we have given away. My apologies, Nana. I didn't mean to overstep you. Nana has been very kind and gracious recently. We have shared some of her tweets. So if you go to her channel, Nana's Karamelle, on Twitter, and follow that, she has been posting, I would say, about every week, a giveaway of some sort. So that's so sweet of her, isn't it?
She has been very, very kind and giving, hasn't she?
And she has 2 giveaways right now that you can...
2?
Yes, you can wait until the show, after the show is over. Yeah, don't worry about it. You can get them anytime today. But there is, let's see here, Nana's current pet snack. Nana, if you're listening, let me know if there's any, or anybody at Nana's Karamelle Delights, please correct me if I say any of this wrong. Nana's current pet snack code. This was the latest, just recently announced, I believe. Wisterios. I don't have text on the screen. I did not prepare that, but don't worry. Just go to Nana's Karamelle at Twitter, and you can get all the information on these. That code, Wisterios, and I hear Wisterios are pretty good. It's good until Sunday at 11:59 Central Time. We're in Central Time, so we always go off of that. So if you ever hear a date and there's no like Pacific Central or what have you, it's probably Central. And then tonight at 11:59 Central Time again, the end of last week's Choco Waffles code. Choco Waffles. So if you don't know how to spell that, again, go to Nana's Karamelle Delights, grab those two after the show, no rush. And then
you know, Matthew.
Yes.
Spark.
Yes.
Bat Masterson. You know I forgot to have breakfast this morning, right? So it's a really good thing that Nana supplied us with these delicious choco waffles. Yeah. Didn't you know it's part of a balanced and nutritious meal?
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure. Choco waffle, toast, eggs, cereal, milk, a bottle of vitamins, and you're good to go for a couple hours. It's great. Fantastic.
Wonderful.
Mm. Yummy.
Hmm. Well, I have one other thing that I actually wanted to slip in here
chocolatey.
Real quick. I have these, I don't know, they were sent by Nana and I don't know what they are. It's a mystery package. She seems to like to do that. Some good chocolate cookies there. So, real quick, winners of National Dog Day that we had a couple days ago. It's National Dog Day recently.
This was a really rough thing for us to look through.
To decide on which ones. Yeah, we had to select five because each one wins some crowns, and we're going to announce those at the end of the show, so I wanted to make sure you guys knew that in case you were like, hey, I submitted a photo on Twitter and Facebook
very
for
important.
That. Yeah. And I believe...
Probably the most important thing we could do, because this is so cute.
Yeah.
So much fun.
And I believe National Cat Day is coming up some point. Mm-hmm. So all you cat owners, be ready for that.
Yeah, I'm a little sad that on Reptile Day a couple weeks ago, I didn't get the big one out of there. So next year we'll have to
reptiles have a day?
Yeah.
Everything has a day. Don't you know that?
Yeah.
Crazy.
It is. After Kaylee and I work on this together with a couple of our team members, which days should we talk about? And we're always happy to hear from the community on, like, it's a national holiday, it's a world holiday, or some sort of event that we should mention, especially if there's some tie into one of our games. And we see everything. There's, like, a day for everything. So let's not digress on that. I wanted to make sure I got this in before I forgot, because this came in in mail, direct mail, not email, regular mail, to our office. Well, in this case, my place in this instance. And it is from a real good friend of ours in the industry, and I wanted to make sure I gave a shout out to him and his work with the Walter Day Collection. The Walter Day Collection has been going on for years now. You can go to thewalterdaycollection.com if you're curious what we're talking about here, and they will have every year different, they're like trading cards. I think I can, the lighting's not going to be great, but just yeah, see, there's one from KingsIsle themed, and there's a little number there that tells you what the type of the trading card is.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, here's a Pirate 101 one.
It's,
apologies again, a little
there
blurry.
Yeah, that's sweet.
Skull Island nice there.
Done.
And this one is a Wizard 101.
Oh, cool.
Or Wizard City specifically. Yeah, and these are trading cards, got a whole bunch. We have to figure out how to give these out to the community. We weren't ready this KI Live, but we're going to make sure there's a chance for maybe at some point some of you to maybe win some of these somehow. We're gonna see if we make that happen. At the very least, we thank the Walter Day Collection for those. And they're in history now. 2020, this is a Wizard 101 and Pirate 101 and KingsIsle 2020 for their collection. So I just want to show
that's
you
fantastic.
That. Yeah.
That's so cool.
I think we are done with the introductory stuff and all my chit chat. So I know you guys want to see some things and talk about some things together,
yeah.
Sam and Adam. And I believe Adam, I found this. I don't know if it has anything to do with the little silhouette teaser thing in the beginning, but I'm just going to show this image, and I think this came from Nana, and you were working on it. Let me switch it over here. There it is. Okay, so anybody on the show, if you're not watching the live stream, you won't see this. Adam, you know what this is. What am I showing the community here?
Oh, it's the
one.
Apple Brut.
Yep. Yeah, the
Apple
one.
Apple Brudel.
The one we talked
about.
Sorry. the Brudel.
Brudel.
How is it pronounced?
Brudel. Brudel.
Brudel.
All right.
Rhymes with strudel. The Brudel.
All right. It has been proclaimed.
Yep. Yeah. Well, so it's basically like a toaster strudel come to life with Apple, coming out the back and out the ears and all that fun stuff.
We love playing with the words. I know every time I stopped in to Sam's office when we were in the office and talking about the story and characters and, hey, I need more information on, you know, this particular creature or what have you, there was always a little story behind it, a little twist of like, oh, it's a cookie in this case, or a strudel in this case, or what have
Somebody
you.
Somebody says it looks like a pastry zergling.
There you go.
Nice. Yeah. So we know you do concepts for just about everything that goes into Wizard and some of our other games as well. How do you take the words of our creative team and translate that into an image? That seems like magic to me. Like, that seems like it has to have a wand.
Yeah. Usually that's what happens, but sometimes I have to draw.
Okay. So there is some drawing involved. All right.
Just a little bit. But usually I'll look at reference, look at, you know, the style of the game, look at other stuff we've done in the past just to get a little bit of inspiration, and then go from there and apply, you know, just some of the stuff from my like visual library and, just, you know, things that I like and translate that into like an interesting creature, like a cool weapon or, a mount or, you know, something that's really interesting, a little bit, different and unique.
Cool. It's always cool to make things different and unique. Mm-hmm. So can you describe what happens from there? You finish up this Apple Brudel. How does that get into game?
So usually, you know, I'll finish a piece. So we'll send it to the modelers, and they'll make, you know, the model and the texture, give it a nice color and all that stuff. If effects are needed, like, you know, if something has like steam or smoke or something like that, you know, give it to the effects and they'll do their pass on it. Animation will then, you know, give it life and make it move and have a lot of emotion, a lot of expression, all that stuff. And then from there, it goes in the game.
Very cool. Alrighty. So you do both environment and character concepts, and I mean some other stuff as well, but those are the two main things. So which is your favorite? Let's start with which is your favorite. What do you like doing, characters or environments?
I think I like characters just a little bit more. I've been, you know, a little bit more interested in environments in recent past, but characters are still my favorite. I like, you know, having different expressions and different designs for, you know, the faces and all that. Clothing designs, like doing the player gear designs, is always, you know, a treat, just because you get to design, you know, the characters, what they'll wear, what they'll look like, and all that.
And you kind of capture their personality. You have to know who they are and what they're thinking to make them look the way that they should. Mm-hmm. That's
and the writers always have really great descriptions and all that. It makes it a lot easier to get the exact look we need in the game.
So. Cool. Mm-hmm. And so what's the biggest, you kind of talked about what you have to do with characters. What's the biggest challenge in an environment? Like, what's the hardest thing about capturing an environment?
For me, it's usually just getting the overall feel for the environment, like the overall, like, you know, if you're looking at an environment being like pulled away from it, it's basically like just the establishing shot, like trying to understand like the mood and how
that dome three-quarter type shot. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Just trying to get like enough of an idea down that the modelers will have a good idea of what to make the environment look like.
Yeah, like characters, if you could almost just draw it so that somebody could just model it and do it as is. If with an environment, you don't have time to draw out every single detail of the environment, so you're really just capturing an essence, right?
Mm-hmm. And just do like little details. It'll, you know, pull out just like, oh, here's a house. This is what this looks like. Here's what the door looks like. Here's what the windows look like. Just little things like that, just to give them an idea. And they usually just fill in all the rest of it. And, you know, of course, it looks amazing.
I just flashed the Apple Brudel one more time there, just to bring it back to the character. I didn't have any environment concept art. I don't know. Maybe for the next show we'll have something. Who knows?
Yep.
Perhaps. I mean, we've got a lot of stuff we're working on. We just can't spoil it all at once. Yeah. So, Adam, last question. What is your favorite concept you've ever done for us? Something that's in-game that's released. Like, what's your favorite thing you've done?
It's probably the sword that you get with the Celestian Spellament pack, I think is what the
Ooh,
pack,
something very the, recent, yeah.
It's, you know, it's got the circular blade, it's got the little galaxy in the middle, and the little kind of like, you know, light blade on the outside. And like the steel is kind of got a Damascus steel, which is, it kind of looks like wood, but it's metal and it's, you know, kind of smooshed together, and it creates this really nice texture. And, you know, in the concept, you know, you can go crazy. And I'm really glad that, you know, in the, you know, the in-game model looks pretty much spot on.
Yeah, you have no bounds. Like, your creativity can go as mm-hmm. crazy as you want. But then when we have to put it in game, there's laws yeah. and rules that we have to mm-hmm. apply. So it's always awesome when, you know, your creativity can just be captured and it mm-hmm. looks real close to it. So cool. Yep. Is there anything else you'd like to say to the community out there?
How about your Twitter channel? You post a lot of your concepts yeah. there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can check out my Twitter account. I post up all the concepts that I do for Wizard 101. It's my handle is Adam Roush 2. So just first name, last name, number 2. That's where you can find that one.
And you have a pretty regular, not to set a schedule for the community here, but you know, you post when yeah. you can, and we actually, mm-hmm. I talked to you about this recently, we actually put a few of those concepts in a spotlight of our newsletters. So we'll have the regular 101 newsletter to go out every month, and in fact, we're working on the next month's right now. Well, not mm-hmm. right now, but we are wrapping it up, and I put a few of the highlights of your recent work in there. So if you know you don't get a chance to get over to Adam's Twitter account, have no fear. We pick some of the really good ones out for the newsletter.
Well, fantastic. Sorry, I'm just getting watching chat. I have a question. Can I 0908? I can't pronounce your name. I have a question. Why is the apple creature so cute? It's going to give me a heart attack.
Ooh, another chance for me to show it.
Sorry.
Okay, here it is. Why is it so cute?
I don't know. It just is. They're just made that way. That's great. So, Sam, I have some questions for you.
Okay.
All right. So, this was a little bit of a... I don't know, a little bit controversial with you making Karamelle. Why were you so hesitant to do Karamelle as the next world?
Oh boy, and so many remarks got taken so far. Okay, so here's the deal.
I wanted to give you a chance to clarify.
We'll clear the air. Ever since I came in and we started talking about worlds for Arc 4 and what we were gonna do, Karamelle has always come up, and I know initially my initial reaction was, well, what can you really do with it? It's Candy World, eh? And so I was like, how can we sustain that for 80 quests and 75 fights and all of that? And I saw it, my initial impression was just be a one-note joke, and what will we do with that? And also looking at how the meta plot of Arc 4 was shaping up with, you know, the crisis and the struggle and all of that, I didn't see Karamelle necessarily fitting into that. But then in discussions, Marvelous team started approaching it from different angles, and I realized that, oh yeah, we could do this with it, and we could do that with it, and we could do that with it. And there was one pun that totally sold me on it, and I'm not going to tell you what it is.
So mysterious.
Yes, there was one thing where I was like, oh, okay, yeah, that totally works where it is in Arc 4, and we're totally going to do that. Okay, that's fine.
Okay, I just wanted to clarify from the chat. They're like, 80 quests, that was a general number. there's not exactly 80 quests. Number. Yeah.
Yes. I will say that looking at how big a world is, my initial thought is we look at fights. How many fights have we got? You know, that was the training I got back in Pirate 101 days. Was how many fights is it? Is there a fight in this environment? If there's not, you're wasting it. So there you go.
Well then, all right. So what's the biggest challenge with Karamelle? I know why now you have fallen in love with it and want to make the world. What's the biggest challenge with Candy World?
The biggest challenge really is trying to do something a little different. And this ties into the how does it fit into Arc 4. If you look, there's a lot of the wizard worlds that basically fall into the same model, the same pattern. And so, you know, oh, there's a bad guy and they're doing something. Let's go to a bunch of places and stop it. And I looked at ways that we could play with that paradigm and try to shift things around a little bit so that at the end of it, you look back and you're looking at it in a very different way. And of course, there's going to be conflict, and of course, there's going to be bad guys. But when we do our reveal, I'm hoping that we can really set up Arc 4 as being significantly different from stuff that's gone before. That was the challenge that I put to us when we started brainstorming, and so far, so good.
And every arc's had its own character and own feelings, so this one will feel a little different. Yeah.
Oh yeah, definitely.
All right.
That was good idea from Silver Lily here, which I wish we would have thought of. Cotton candy pet with little paper cone arms.
That is a good idea.
Thought of that one.
That would be cute and delicious.
Yeah.
But would you really want to eat your pet? That wouldn't be good. I don't know.
Sorry, I derailed us.
Speaking of derailing, segue. How
Let's
about
just get derailed completely?
Yeah, why not? Here we have that. I talked about that giveaway. Well, let's show the partial code and see if you guys can guess it. And I change this up every time. You get it within like 5 seconds, and then
are you
it's
gonna
out
make it
there.
More difficult this time?
I did. I put no guesses. No, I'm just kidding. I put a couple of guesses in.
Just
here.
Guess from the ether.
Okay. Now we've been on a roll here recently with you guys guessing. Let's see if you can get this one. Remember that you. If you redeem it, and you don't have to right now, you have until 6 o'clock Central Time. That's about, depending on how long we go, half hour before, after we conclude the show. And you will get, by redeeming, a Wizard 101, 2 Rockhammers jewel packs, and for Pirate 101, 2 Tribal Crew packs. So, 4 packs. And the parcel code is right there. Code guess. And the ending is always the same. I wouldn't put that in there because I know you guys know what that is, and maybe I should just fill it in, but you know what? It might change someday, so who knows?
Somebody mentioned a cotton candy wand. That, I mean, I'm
I think that here. Fits the theme for you, Professor Filmy.
That's a pretty
you
cool
have, Yeah, you have a little wand there. All right. Where's my wand? Well, I don't have any wand. I just have this cotton. Delicious bag of Nana's Caramels, some sort of cookie.
It's okay. All right, Sam.
Yeah.
If you can, without giving it away, what's your favorite pop culture reference that's in Karamelle? Or would that be, is that too much of a spoiler?
No, it's okay. In fact, I'm feeling so generous today, I'm going to give you two.
Ooh.
One of them, I'm not going to tell you what it is, but I'm going to tell you that it's in one of the spells. And the
spells.
Other one,
we have a question later on spells chat. So yeah, no, well,
have
chat's
I,
been no, no,
have
no,
I
no,
said too much.
No, it's okay. you absolutely can talk about spells, but we've seen a lot
get,
of
when you
hey,
get
spells.
At,
yeah.
Yeah. When you get a look at that, you'll immediately know what I'm talking about. And the other one, I would have to say, it was fun in Aquila to have Arnold Schwarzenegger referenced. It's going to be very fun in Karamelle to have the Sylvester Stallone riff that we have. So, as soon as that was conceived of. As soon as the joke happened, I was like, that's it, we're doing it. So that's going to be
hilarious.
And they already got the code. I have been foiled again.
You can't stop. You can't stop the chat.
So I guess I'll show it here. We have such an amazing community in our chat. So proud of you guys for guessing this one. Next one, I am going to twist it, and you will not guess it. We'll see.
No. Maybe we'll keep them from getting it.
They keep me on my game.
30 seconds instead of 15. Yeah.
Exactly. So here it is in full. Rock Crew 2020. It was actually a little challenging to come up with it because I wanted to keep it short and simple for you guys at the end of the day. You can redeem that anytime until 6 Central Time today. And if you do happen to miss that, don't worry again. We always give you another chance at something. This show will go on go on YouTube, hopefully tomorrow. And when you see it on YouTube and we announce it on social media and all that good stuff, we'll throw in another 1,000 codes there for those who just get that news as well. So another chance for that. And also, as another and, I never mentioned this before, but do follow our newsletters when you see those announced as well. And those will, I think next week we're going to announce those. We once again have a special opportunity for you to get more stuff. That code may open once more for those who read the newsletter. But all limited time. So you gotta get it while you can.
All right. Very cool. So Sam, I have more questions for you.
More for me?
Okay. So taking it away from Karamelle, because it's hard to talk about Karamelle because there's so much we want to talk about, but so many spoilers. Let's go to the wide spiral. What's your favorite world that we've done so far and why?
There's a bunch of ways to approach that question, and I'm going to drone on and on like I sometimes do.
Please.
I will say, in terms of purely from a story and writing standpoint, I really, really dig Chrysalis. Not necessarily because of its tone and its darkness, but I really like it because it is not Western European medieval fantasy. It is not analogous to something within the world. I thought visually it was really striking. And also, that was the first time with little cinematic bits and whatnot that the game really started to show the possibilities for story within the game that hadn't really been used to their fullest. And now, you know, to this day, we keep doing them and we keep trying to find out exactly how much is too much. But so from a story standpoint, I really dig Chrysalis. I'm also very fond of Avalon, but that's just because I'm an Anglophile.
Yeah, Avalon's one of my favorites. And definitely, I think when we polled people, it was definitely up there in the top couple. So
it's also gorgeous. So,
very much. Okay, last question. Is there anything you wanted to highlight or talk about from the last arc that maybe not everybody got, or something that you want to point out, a cool moment? I'm leaving it vague so that you can impress us with something.
Only having done the last third of the last arc, I'm not sure how deep I can go into that question. I will say the thing that I enjoyed most was some of the pop culture riffing that we got to do with Pork and Spark and all of them. But I also think that the growth of a character, one character who you see across multiple worlds, that was really the first time we'd tried to do that, other than it being, you know, a quest giver that you go back to. But, you know, with Mallory, we see a story from beginning to end. And the Mallory we end up with is not the Mallory from the beginning of the story. And that was really cool. And I give props to the writing team for Polaris and that other world, Mirage, And so I was very, you know, I was very honored to carry that to its conclusion. That to me was, of all the nifty story stuff, that was fun. And the other thing was, I loved every second of writing and thinking up Reverie. And
yes, that was one of my favorite moments in all of Wizard as well.
And I was very pleased with how it turned out. And yes, we were completely trolling you the whole time. And that's why you fight, you know, not one Belloc, but four. Yes, everything was very deliberate.
I'm actually in a reverie right now here.
So many of you picked up on it.
This is one of my favorite areas as well, because it's, you know, just kind of floating out there. So I'm going to switch over there. Apologies, by the way, for me running out. I put a sign on the door saying, live stream in progress. Please do not disturb. And guess what? Somebody knocked on the door.
I say Belloc is one of my favorite characters.
There we go.
Game. I can't wait to see him over and over again. I hope he comes back.
So there you go. You get to see the area. I'm just showing it. Sam and Adam and all of you know that you can't see it right now, but I am here. There's really nowhere immediate to go, so I'm just standing here next to Lady Katie and Nicholas Owl. Hey, Lady Katie and Nicholas Owl. Nicholas Owl specifically. Welcome. We have players here just hanging out with us. So they are in-game, not just in Twitch chat as well. So they say hi to Sam and Adam today.
Hello.
And I will switch back to you guys. I have not actually switched back to the game really at all today because we've had such great questions from the community and responses by you guys that I figured just, you know, I mean,
We have more of them, much more.
And we have more. So, all right. Well, there was a little bit of gameplay break there for you very briefly. So more questions.
More questions. Actually, I believe that we have a random fact from Kaylee.
We do. So for those who don't know, I plan and run our entire promotional email program. So basically what that means is if you send an email to like the community email address, that's not me, that's Matthew. Likewise, if you send an email to customer support, that is also not me, that's customer support. But when you get
that is not me either. Customer
that is also not Matthew. They're a separate department.
We do talk to each other, of course, and we will get you to where you need to be. But like, you know, Twitter responses, you know, we'll see those, but we may have to say, hey, you know, please contact customer support, or we will say, hey, go here for more information.
Yep, they are the one that have the tools to deal with any issues that come up. So,
but yeah, any emails you get that have like fancy graphics telling you about a sale or an event or an update, those are all me. I write all those. I plan when we send them, what's in them. So I wanted to give a random email fact. So on average, we send roughly around 2,670,200 promotional emails a week. So
that's a lot.
Yes,
that was a big number.
And you handcraft each one of those.
Most of them, I write the copy for.
No,
yeah.
Like each. No, I mean like oh, each copy. No, of
yeah, them. Each individual so one. So.
We write them on.
That's
paper.
How I spend all my time.
Dear so and so two. Dear so. Yeah.
Sincerely, Kaylee.
Yeah. There you go.
And so I pulled the stats for last month, and the total number of emails we sent in July 2020 was, again, this is just promotional emails, this is 929,800.
You couldn't even get to a cool million?
Yeah, you couldn't.
We're so close.
Okay. Well, maybe next time.
You got to have time. Something to strive for.
Yes.
Someone just asked how they sign up for the promo emails.
So you have to log into the website, then go to your account, then manage, and there should be a checkbox depending on if you want to subscribe to Wizard 101 or Pirate 101.
Or both. Do both.
Yeah, that works too. We like both.
And from the chat, no, I do not run support. There's a lovely, wonderful person who runs support, and she's awesome, and it's not me. just making sure. So we had a lot of people submit some Twitter questions ahead of time, and we kind of picked the ones that might be more skewed towards our story this time. So Sam, I'm going to be kicking a lot of these your way.
Okay.
There's a couple that I'll get out of the way pretty quickly because I. Pooter Balik asks, when can we expect the release of Test Realm of Karamelle?
Yeah, when it's ready.
That's the simple.
It's in the oven right now, and Nana's not going to pull it out until it's ready.
Yeah, the cake has to rise.
We have to talk to Nana.
Yeah, what I wanted to make sure the community knew is we spilled the beans, the Boston baked beans, since, you know, candy. We spilled the beans on this one a lot earlier than normal. Usually we start talking about a world maybe a month or so before we go. We're a little further out.
A little over 2 months now, I think.
We will not be releasing to test before we have another KI Live. I can tell you that for sure. So
we have one more KI Live as an opportunity, at least one more, to show some stuff.
We'll be releasing information about it, but just so you know, we spilled the beans on this one a little earlier than normal because we're just so excited. It's just so cool. Next question is Ellie. Will we get some updated hair textures? And the answer is there's nothing new planned on the horizon right now, but since we updated the character models and they look awesome, and we have the new character system, we'll definitely consider doing that in the future. Our artists right now are like 100% on Karamelle, but in the future, we'll look into it. Sam, are you asking questions here? Sam Blue?
I am not.
That's not you? Okay. What are the plans for the upcoming Wizard 101 birthday, and how is KI planning to celebrate it with social distance? In game, the great thing about it is the Spiral is totally social distance friendly. There'll be birthday celebrations. I know we have had meetings and talked about what's going in there. So there's some gifts and cool stuff going on, just like all the other years. And for us at KI, I'm not sure what that's going to mean because we won't be in the office. We'll probably have a socially distanced cake or cheese day or something like that together.
Cheese day.
Yeah.
We have a little celebration in the game right now here. More players have joined me as I just kind of idle here and as you guys are chatting. So I'm swapping randomly over to the game as all of these players in the game say hi to our guests.
Nice. Hello. Hello. Thanks for joining us. So more questions. These are going to start going to Sam here. Miles Fan asks, what inspired the upcoming world, assuming it's Karamelle? And come on, we announced this last time. It's Karamelle. It is absolutely Karamelle. So, Sam, what inspired the upcoming world?
There's a few things that I'm not going to go into. Really, in terms of look and feel and all of that, we really wanted to go with an Alpine feel, an Austria, Bavaria, Switzerland kind of a feel. It's not something we've done before, and it lends itself to chocolate and such things, and the accents can be really funny if you do them right. And that, believe it or not, is usually a factor when we start figuring this stuff out. It's like, oh, it can be really funny if we go there. So that sort of thing.
Do you have an accent for us? I can try one myself. Can't, no guarantee on success.
I am not going to do one now. No.
Aww.
Although, if all goes well, I will end up doing some VO for Karamelle. We shall see.
Very cool. All right. So this is another one. Scooby-Doo asks, Scooby-Dooby-Doo, in the new world, will we get new spells? The answer is absolutely yes. We have new spells coming out. We are making them now. They are very, very, very cool. I'm not going to spoil what they are yet. You'll have to wait, but we cannot wait for you to see them. So yes, there will be new spells. And so here's the ones that I have flagged. Sam, Nicola asks, will Malorian Bat be included in the fourth arc?
I don't know.
You don't know, or you don't want to say?
Well, I don't really want to say. I guess I have to step back and end up with maybe. I think there's a lot from the third arc. If you know, Mallory is cool enough that that she would always be welcome back. But I'm hoping that we can go in newer directions and make newer people. But we'll see.
All right.
Maybe.
I mean, I know that those are two fairly beloved characters from the last arc. I know Bat and Batbot are friends of Vanessa Mythdust. So if she has anything to say about it, they'll probably be making a reappearance. But anywho, more questions. Banana Brian. Okay, great name. What's the most tedious part of creating a new world? And so I'm going to answer like the overall, and then I'll pass it off to other folks to talk about their part. So new world is like a labor of love. We love undertaking them, but man, it's so much work. I would say it probably takes writing the longest because they're involved in it for about a year. It takes about a year to make a new world. And probably the most volumistic part of it is art, because the art team is the biggest team that has to create it. We have about 15 or 20 artists, and it takes about a third of the year to create. And the most squished is sound at the end, because they get all the pieces right at the end and they have to make their stuff very quickly. So that's probably the most tedious or challenging part overall. Sam, on the story side, what's the most challenging for you guys?
In terms of challenging, I would have to say it is the initial brainstorm thing.
Starting with a blank slate.
Yeah, when we have the blank slate. In terms of tedious, as in, oh my God, no more of this. That would be naming. That would be item naming. I will not be coy. I despise naming items, but that's okay. You know,
I understand. I think I helped name about the first 500 items in the game. So.
We're in an MMO. We have to have the items. And I got to tell you, this year it's been weird. What with the world turning upside down and all. Working from home for us has not been that different, because, you know, we're constantly in touch and whatnot. But the biggest challenge for me this year has been not having whiteboards. Because in the little room that I'm jammed into the corner of with my, you know, improv desk station, I have no wall space, and not being able to scribble stuff down or draw stuff or whatnot, you know, it was a bigger part of my creative process than I knew.
I agree. I'm missing my whiteboard as well. All right, Adam, is there anything tedious about concepting, or is it just fun to draw everything?
I mean, yeah, there's definitely some difficulty just trying to interpret what the writers put down into a way that we can make work. You know, just trying to make it stylized enough, you know, without being too realistic. You know, just trying to find the right style, like the balance of things that are realistic and cartoony, and translate that into wizard style. That's, you know, a little bit of a challenge there. Just coming up, again, just trying to think about the overall world and put everything into perspective and into design and style and all that stuff. So, I mean, there's plenty of challenge there, but it is overall enjoyable. So.
All right. Well, that's good. I'm glad you, I mean, you do wonderful work. You have to enjoy your job, right? If you're doing such a good job.
Yeah.
All right. Next question, the Unluck Cat. What other types of sweets will Nana's Karamelle Twitter have at her shop? And I'm going to say you got to keep an eye on the Twitter. She's announcing new products all the time. Yeah. Keep an eye on the Twitter.
The Unluck Cat that I think the Unluck Cat Twitter there. Whoa. Yeah, I said it should be Kalachi's because if I remember right, he works at a Kalachi shop. But the sweet kind, not the...
We'll put the Nana's Karamelle Twitter link in the chat here for everybody.
I'm very quiet, apparently.
Yes, you are very quiet. This is a Unlike you.
Very unlike me. So what I had said was the unlucky cat, it should be those sweet kolaches.
Ah, all right.
He, I think, works at a kolache shop.
Oh, nice. So we have another cat question. Pacey the cat says, do you plan on changing the treasure cards of the spells that have undergone change? Example, the Freed Gnome, Sirens, etc. And DC has had an answer for this.
Oh, which one? Planning on changing the TC spells that undergone change. Okay.
Pay attention. Pay attention.
I'm answering people. Oh, gosh. Okay. So the plan currently is that we will end up phasing out the treasure cards in packs. Eventually, the ones that you'll get in the pack will be just the base version of it, and it will be properly balanced. The old cards will be there. If you have them, you'll be able to keep them if you want. You can play them, but they're treasure cards, so once they're used and they're gone. So that's my current plan on that. I still need to talk to Ratbeard and make sure that's working with him and Matt Nedek, because, you know, he's in charge of spells. So, but when it comes to the special versions of treasure cards that came from packs, eventually they'll just be replaced with the proper ones.
All right. You actually got an exclusive here, because apparently that's not approved yet.
Yeah, well, I'm just telling people my plan.
All right, so do know that we understand that the treasure cards that are part of the spells that are rebalanced, they're the same values as they always have been. That is most likely going to change. So last two questions, I have notes. Sam! Exclamation mark. So let's kick those to Sam. Zachary, why didn't the Arcanum help the spiral against Malastare and Morganth? Why did they jump in when they did? What do you think, Sam?
Well, I'm going to answer that question with a question. Who says they didn't? So I'll leave you with that.
Oh, everybody ponder that one for three or four years.
That might be the most damn answer I've ever heard.
Ah, I love it. Okay. And last official question. Indie Seeker asks, what exactly happened to the poor Storm Titan, after we defeated him? If he's dead, how is Storm Magic still working? Sam?
Well, that's a good question. Storm Magic is still working. So clearly something too horrible can't have happened to him. But also bear in mind that when he was defeated, he was, shall we say, not quite himself. So, there's some stuff going on there. It's a little further into the realm of the cosmic than I want to go at this time. So I'll just sum up by saying that would be telling.
Oh, love the cliffhangers. Love the very, very vague hints there. So Nana wanted me to remind everybody that if they see a witch, they should scream, scram, and get some ice cream. Nana brand specifically. So Sam, what's a witch? Should we fear them? Should we scream and scram?
More importantly, should we have ice cream?
I think the answer is you should always have ice cream, but should you scream?
Pretty much, yeah. You should always have ice cream. Witches, well, witches, they're generally frowned upon in Karamelle. But in terms of exactly what they are and what they're up to, all I can say is you'll find out.
I'll follow Nana's advice there and scream and scram. Yeah.
I'll follow the ice cream part. That sounds delicious either way.
I'm with you on that.
All right. So I think that's it for the official questions.
Cool.
Decius, did you have anything you wanted to?
I have two things. First of all, if Sestiva is out there, get it together. Get it together, Sestiva. Get it together.
Aww.
And don't forget to take care of those pets. And part two, there's been some confusion about how spellements are dropped in game. and how they are dropped in packs and how they come out of the different events. So I wanted to say now, be very clear about it. Currently, the tier one spell elements first came out in the Decathlon Towers. About a month after the Decathlon Towers came out, I would put them into a spell elemental pack. About a month after they were in the spell elemental pack, I started putting them on the Skeleton Key bosses. The tier two ones have only been in the packs and Skeleton Key bosses, and I usually give them the pack a full month before I put it onto the Skeleton Key boss drops. So there's some exclusivity there, but they are coming. They all will be able to be farmed for the one and twos off Skeleton Key bosses over the next couple months. So just be patient. They'll be there. As for spells coming up in the future that might be spell element, we are still working our way through this and figuring out the best way to get them all out. I'm going to also start looking at the number of spell elements that people are getting, and we might tune that up depending on how quickly we are hoping that people will be getting them from the fights. I put the percentage on there of how often they'll drop. More often than not, you should be getting one to three for every Skeleton Key fight, but you can get up to 30 or 60 depending on which fight you're in. So there's always a way to go get them, like a month after they've come out in the pack. And that's should be it. Hopefully that answered all your questions. I'm sure I'll get a bunch more.
Well, Matthew, how about some gameplay tips?
Yeah, I think we have a few of those, starting with Pirate 101 from Captain Logan West. Hi, Captain Logan West. How are you doing? When you're questing on two dual-windowed pirates, make sure to teleport one of your pirates into the ship of your second pirate and let your second pirate do the ship's fights. The progress for the ship quest will count for both of your characters. Hey, that's a good one. Not everybody can actually do that, but if you can, there you go. And I think we have a couple more, so Professor Falamea, how about I just roll with those and we get through these really good tips?
Yeah, sure, go for it. I'm trying to see if there's anything in chat that we wanted to talk about, but...
Well, switching it up, back to Wizard 101 here, from Queen Elif, you can craft some fun spells with runes from the Decathlon events, such as the Headless Horseman, Lightning Elf, Leaf Storm, and Catch of the Day. And I feel like we need to clarify a little bit of that for those people who don't know what those are. A little bit like, about the TCs, Professor Falamea?
Oh, sorry. I'm paying attention to chat. So I saw this. I'm like, wait, what? And I realized that they're talking about treasure card spells, not regular spells. That's all.
Yeah.
I just wanted to make sure to clarify.
I try to. There might sometimes be like a one little word tweak just to make sure it's clear to the community. So if you hear your quote and it's like, I didn't put that exact word in there, it's just to make sure it's clarified. We don't change it up for any other reason, obviously. We didn't do that this time. So thank you for Professor Falamea for clarifying that.
No problem.
One more tip here for this is back to Pirate 101 from a shiny horde. We have spend the first turn of a battle boosting your attributes, so strength, agility, will, etc. That is determined by your weapon because any powers will be boosted. So for example, on a privy, a boosted will attribute to increase the effectiveness of fighting fervor. So if you all know all of those, there's your tip.
All right, so I'm trying to pick some stuff up out of chat. It's scrolling really fast.
We're trying to
focus on stuff that is answerable by our story folks or me or the folks that are here.
And I keep getting distracted by Nana. Nana's like tweeting here. Well, she hasn't tweeted yet on her channel today. She seems to tweet quite regularly and is very eager, it seems like. They want to show more stuff. And they see the potential of our KI Lives as doing that. And I said, hey, we have a KI Live as an opportunity to do that. And now they're like, oh, let's do more. It's like, well, we can only show so much right now.
Yeah, we can't spoil everything. As we get closer, we'll start probably showing off more stuff, and I'm sure Nana will show off more stuff too.
Speaking of, if you're curious on a little teaser for what the world looks like, we did have a concept go out that was a couple weeks ago now. Nana's Karamelle, Nana tweeted it. And so you can scroll back in the history all the way to the beginning of her tweets. She's been tweeting for a while now, and you can check out that image. You can also check out, I assume she will have the Apple Brudel concept that we showed briefly here. Let me show that one more time. There it is. And I'm sure she'll tweet that out at some point soon too. And who knows what else in the future.
So I'm again trying to pick stuff out of chat and pay attention to four things. Will there be Elite Ken says, will there be new high level gear when the next world comes out? We do it every time. There's going to be new gear. There will be new gear. Absolutely. Let's see.
And we will name it.
Yes. All 800 million of them.
Actually, I think Magnetic just checked in the stubs for them all. I could tell you how many.
If I remember correctly, it was 830. That's why I came up with the 800 million. Let's see. When will better chat for texters come for Beast Moon? It's actually something that we're looking into now. So we were aware and we're looking into it. Let's see what else. So Sam, will Lydia Grey Rose have a role in Karamelle?
A very peripheral one.
Okay. All right, let's see. So I actually had a question for chat. Anybody that has been reading up on Nana, our fabled, wonderful Nana, does anybody really think that Nana's evil? If you think she's good, type good in the chat. If you think she's evil, type evil in the chat. But you should type good. Because she's good.
She's good.
She's the sweetest.
She has cookies and ice cream.
And choco waffles, and this will give me.
She's so good. I don't understand why people think she's evil.
She really is quite good. Yes.
Snacks, snack giveaways every week. Two snack giveaways right now. It's amazing. Like, who doesn't love that?
It feels like it's about 1/3 good and 2/3 evil. There's, yeah. And there's some clarification there, but it's going by. So, like, good but evil. Bing! All the way off the screen. So, okay, cool. Good to know.
Someone says she's a witch. No, Nana says run from witches.
That's right.
Yeah.
No, she does not. She does not use a cauldron. No.
Let's see. Okay. All right. Awesome. Good to know. Good to know the tone of chat. And... and now I realize I've created a monster because now everything is scrolling way quicker than I can read. Let's see. So, Sam.
Will she's we find... evil. She's holding Kaylee captive. Can't you see?
Oh,
it's not. That's
news to me.
So, Sam, will we find out more about the Cabal in the next arc? Asks Jared Shadowbreaker. Sam, are you
That's
there?
A safe bet.
Okay. All right.
What? Oh, can you not hear me? Is my internet messing up?
No, we do now.
Okay. I would say that's a safe bet.
And also, Celestian Paradox, nice name. Is Sam Johnson sitting in the Valencia Library? Are you?
I wish. I am sitting in a, I'm sitting in a tiny room, but the background behind me is actually one of the references we used when we built that library. And it's very, very nice. I love it a lot. So there you go.
Okay, let's see.
I think some people need to go back to Colossus Boulevard and pay attention to the quest lines there, because they would answer some of the questions they're asking.
Interesting. very interesting. Urs Gaming says Adam Roush knows who Nana really is. Is that true? Do you know?
What? What?
Perfect. Exactly. Okay. Ooh. Sam. I was going to say I can't pronounce this, but it's Jinxed. It's just spelled crazy. Should we expect to hear more from Sybil at the start of this arc?
That would be telling.
before K Alive, we were kind of talking about, you know, what can we say, and I said Sam is going to say this is, or that would be telling at least 5 or 10 times as I answer questions.
That would be telling.
That would be telling.
Yeah, her next appearance will be very interesting. There you go.
Interesting. All right. So let's see. Did the witches kick the gobblers out and then Nana? It's already off the screen. Never mind. Sorry. Did the goblins serve the witches? I think it was. And I'm sure that would also be telling.
Yep.
All right. Yeah.
You're going to have to go find out.
Yep. So, Matthew.
Yes.
What about those dogs? What about those cute puppies?
Yeah, that's right. We had a couple of posts recently. One that we had a blog post, and I believe, correct me if I'm wrong here, Vanessa, but I believe we have a blog post that just went up recently on KingsIsleBlog.com about National Dog Day, right?
Yes, we did. We wanted to show off all of our fluffy coworkers because, you know, we can't work on Karamelle alone. We need some companions to help us, so we showed off some of our cute pets.
Yeah, and our real-life pets here, not the in-game. So, you know, go ahead and check those out. And then we followed that blog post up with a tweet asking for your photos of your pets. And we had quite a variety. We had not just dogs, you know, it was just totally cool. We had some cats in there. We had, I think, a few lizards and a couple of birds and a few others. And so we picked out, we focused on, I think, just dogs here for the top five, because it's National Dog Day. And the top five was kind of a little bit of a collective, you know, who should we pick here? And these five came up, and we're going to show those here right now. I just want to make sure I get the right option here, and we'll show the top five here, announce them, and then each one wins some crowns, and we will reach out, since this was on social media, we'll reach out to all of you who won to award your crowns over the next within the next couple of days here.
I'm so sorry, I have to break in and say that Kaylee is the villain of Karamelle. Sorry, Sam, your plan's ruined.
I'm the true villain.
Mm-hmm. All right, so here we go. Here is the first image, and this one is of Barkley, Scruffy with this is from Barkley, and this is Scruffy, probably on the left, with Spunky. So Scruffy and Spunky. You guys won't until the live stream catches up. And then next we have, here is Gar with Gar's friend, just kind of chilling there, a little bit tired, a little bit, you know, nap time. We all have that every day, a little bit of nap time there. Cute too there, look at that. And then next here, this is from Joe Jonas, and their three dogs. So full house there. We've got, I think it looks like a Labrador, is that a golden retriever, I think? And I love the right one, that's such a cute one. And the middle one's like, I don't know, it looks like, why are you taking a photo of me? What is all this? You know, I just want to relax on the couch here. What is going on? And then the next one here, I like this one. Morgan, from Morgan Moonstone with Boris and his birthday yesterday. So happy birthday, Boris, yesterday.
Oh, I love standard poodles.
And I think That is either it or... Oh, and one more. Look at this cute guy. Zuddy with Zova. Hello, Zova. Such a cute dog. There were so many. Thanks, everyone, who submitted to that tweet. We really appreciate it.
Those pictures brought so much cute. Joy.
Yeah, and you can, if you want to see everybody who submitted a dog, just go on the Twitter channel, which I believe was Wizard... it was KingsIsle, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, KingsIsle. I think we posted that on the KingsIsle, and then because it's National Dog Day, dogs everywhere, we shared that also on the Wizard and Pirate Twitters, I believe, as well. But anyway, it's there, and you can see all of them. And again, there is a cat day sometime, and we'll see if we can do this again, because we want to see all your cats, too. It was fun.
Absolutely. And like I said, it was so rough having to judge those. So rough.
I approve, Leah.
Rough. I'm learning from the master. I'm trying to get my pun game on. So let's see.
I love it.
I saw somebody in chat ask, can we please get all AoE spells to hit all enemies all at once? And the answer is we are looking into them. We have to redo the spells from scratch, the animations from scratch to do that. So it's not something that we can just hit a button and make it happen. It's actually a fairly long and involved process. So we're kind of picking them off as we have the time at the worst offenders like Krulu. You no longer have to go make a sandwich while you wait for it to end. So we'll probably kind of work on chopping those down one by one. Decius.
Yes.
There might have been one or two people, or it might have been one person just over and over, I can't remember, saying that they were interested in double reagents.
Double reagents and double crafting member benefit?
Yeah.
Well, they
might we ever run that again?
I don't think we're ever going to run that again.
No?
No.
Okay.
No.
Sorry. No. Sorry, chat.
No. So as everyone knows, next month is our birthday month, and I run all member benefits throughout the whole birthday month, so that one will be up there.
Hey, Rapbeard, how'd you get in here?
Oh.
Wait, what?
He has appeared.
We summon a rat beard?
What's going on here?
Wait.
Who clicked that button?
Wait, what? I thought you were
busy.
The
chat said his name a million times.
Yeah,
so
okay.
Here he is.
Apparently if rat beard is invoked in chat at least 300,000 times, rat beard appears. So good to know.
That's how it works. No, I just, you know, I'm used to being called on last in the Zoom meetings.
Or forgotten entirely, you know.
But no, I've just been super busy, you know, just doing work over here, working on spreadsheets and, you know, game design documents and, you know, just staying super busy. I didn't want to mess up the symmetry of your screen here to jump in early, so.
Oh, well.
Now it's like we've got two Brady Bunches missing at the bottom.
Oh, there goes go. Sam. He dropped again.
Oh, so maybe we will maintain symmetry.
my internet is really messing with me.
Okay, you can go if you like. Thank you for stopping by.
Yeah, I think I'm going to have to cut out, but I had a great time. We will see y'all in Karamelle.
Goodbye, Sam.
Thank you for all the information and the questions that you have raised. I appreciate it.
Bye-bye, everybody. Yep.
Bye, Sam.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bring in magnetic. No.
There, we're back in symmetry mode.
Oh, yeah, we got the symmetry now.
We're better. We don't need it. No.
If Ratbeard is busy, Matnetic is, like, double busy. You guys do want the new world. And, like,
and if I am not busy, then Matnetic is triple busy.
Yeah, you just, like, said, hey, Matnetic, here, do some of my work. I'm going to go play on KLI for a while, right?
He's in the chat somewhere. I know
it.
I know.
It's good to be boss, right?
He's been helping moderate today along with Paul Minotaur. So that's wonderful.
Awesome.
Yeah, Ratbeard equals Candyman. You're right. That's what chat says.
So you're going to nerf everyone's spells, right?
Yeah, you're here to nerf spells and to fix PvP. That's what we're doing, right?
And chew Nana's bubblegum.
Yeah.
Nana doesn't make bubblegum.
I think
so
Nana's all out of bubblegum.
Exactly. All right. We'll see.
All right.
Well, we didn't have any impromptu questions for you.
No,
I don't have anything else myself here. So I don't know how much longer we want to go. Otherwise,
Ratbeard, was there anything you came on to say, or did you just come on to say hi to everybody?
No, I just, you know, I didn't want to miss the party. It seemed like it was, you know, just fun stuff going on here.
Yeah, so.
There you go.
Yeah, we got a, we got like a full room here right now in game that we got. I'm gonna switch over right here real quick, and a bunch of players are joining us in the game, just kind of hanging out as well.
See, Ratbeard, yeah. any tips on game design? That's not a very large and broad question.
Yes, and that it's a simple one, is you can't please all the people all the time. That's an easy one. So, you know, actually that comes up a lot. You know, people like to say that, you know, KingsIsle doesn't listen to feedback. And unfortunately, that often means they don't listen to my feedback. I mean, we try to listen to all the feedback, but... you know, even inside one community, like for example, the PvP community, you know, it's not just one community. There's lots of people in there. They all have different competing interests. And so they all give us different advice on how, you know, how they think that we should address things. And of course we have our own goals that we're working towards as well. So, we do listen and we take, you know, we try to take all opinions into account. But at the end of the day, game design is about trying, you know, trying to satisfy the most people in the most satisfactory way that you can. And it's not easy, but we try.
I'm not Ratbeard, but I have a thing to say. Make games. Just go make games. If you're interested in game design, the best way to learn is to go make games. There's lots of resources Absolutely. Out there. And a lot of people think the hardest part of making a game is coming up with a game. It's really not. The hardest part of a game is actually taking that idea and making it something playable. So if you can go out and do that, if you can take tools and make that yourself, and if you want to get into game design, that's going to give you a huge leg up when you go to an interview and say, hey, I made this game. Even if it's not great, it shows that you've had, you can take an idea and take it through a process to be something playable. So I just wanted to say that. Mm-hmm. So Matthew, do you have anything else that you want to chat about?
I think I'm good, actually. We have, let me throw up the code here one more time. So this is Rock Crew 2020. This is the code for KI Live here. You can redeem it within another 45 minutes, 6 p.m. Central Time. We'll have the show up on Friday on YouTube as well. And don't forget to check Nana's Caramel Twitter account, because I believe right now, still, there is two snack codes from her that are active.
There are. And there's also some delicious choco waffles. So.
Ooh, wow, that looks, that does look delicious. I have like mini
ones. The delicious part of a balanced breakfast. You only have to have a bottle of vitamins with it, and it's great. Wonderful.
Somebody in the chat wanted to know if we're this fun off KI Live or if it's all business, and I'd say we're pretty fun.
Yeah, it's the game industry. So
yeah.
I've always said that if you can't have fun while making games, you might as well just make toilet paper rolls, so.
Very true.
Serious.
There you go.
Work, but most of the time,
I mean, you have to be serious. It is a business, and we do have to be serious and get work done. But if you can't have fun while doing it, you might as well do something else.
Yeah, I mean, you guys know, like, the game, there's so many, you know, characters and sayings and phrases and stuff that you kind of like, oh, that's funny. I recognize, you know, where it came from elsewhere, perhaps, and how it ties in with, you know, different worlds. And, you know, Sam was just talking about that earlier and the fun their team has in writing all of these characters in their quotes. And so that should give you a hint that we put a lot of fun into this game, and we have a lot of fun doing it.
Absolutely. I feel like we have one more person that wants to crash it for me really quick.
Another? Ooh, okay. Who's that? I don't know who this is. This is fun. Speaking of fun, let's see. Oh, okay. So I gotta admit them. That actually shows on... I think that was up for Ratbeard for a while, and they were wondering, like... He's in the waiting room, and this person's in the waiting room too. Let me admit.
So I've seen a couple of this in chat, and I forgot to answer it. So people have talked about a new level cap. Typically, when we have new worlds, there are new levels. I don't believe that this one's going to be any different. So,
I wish we had a Make Wiz HD button.
Is there a button?
Apparently, Kyle's D1122 says that we just need to hit the Make HD button.
Because it's a shame that we spent you years and years of art time doing it instead of just hitting that button. That would have been really nice to know.
Hello, mystery person.
Hello.
Hello.
I heard that there was fun going on here. And according to Jira, you actually have a lot of work to do.
Caught. Oh. Well, on that note...
Kick Renee out. We have to go back to fly.
Can I do that? I think I can do that.
Renee, I figured you were going to come on and show off your puppy.
Oh.
We're Sadie.
Hello, Sadie.
She's hanging out. Just sleeping, actually.
But, okay.
She's in the blog post that Kaylee made, so
be sure to check that out. She is.
And also, I'm very proud of you today, chat.
Chat has been really, really nice today. It's like Nana says, be sweet, not sour.
Yes.
The chat has taken Nana's advice.
Chat's been great today. Thank you all so much.
Yes.
We were at like 1,500 people.
Wow,
and
that's
I think
amazing.
We only banned one person today.
Awesome. That's great. Nice. And with that note, let's leave it on a great note. Everybody, thank you for joining us on KI Live here, August 2020. Stay tuned for the next one. We always have something for you. New special guests, maybe more surprise guests. Who knows? This at-home style has its benefits, obviously. And so we hope you enjoyed everything that you saw today. And don't forget to sign up to Nanak's Karamelle Twitter account to keep watch on potentially more coming out from Nana about Karamelle.
Absolutely. And we'll certainly keep you abreast of all the news from Nana, and Nana's gonna keep tweeting because Nana loves the tweeting, and we'll have more teasers for you coming in the next month, and then we'll come back and do KA Live. And I think all that's left for me to say is have an old-fashioned delightful day. See ya.
Bye.